Hello, 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 everybody. Good morning, good day, and good night, wherever and whenever you're watching my From Signals Info Show. My name is Dilda Megalic from Good Old Germany, and you're welcome to another technical, another 48 hours, of course, technical analysis and synthesis. Tonight, Central European time, of course, with the cable, another major one. So the pound dollar, here is it. Analyze the stuff again, it's still yours. Okay, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, welcome again. It's 1:07 Central PM time in the morning, Friday morning, Friday the 3rd February 2012, or 8 minutes after midnight in London, or 19:08 on Tuesday or Thursday evening in New York. Here we see, before we starting with the last 22 hours of this week. Okay, so let's get started. I've got a little bit cliffhanger. It's 1:11 Central European time, Friday, of course. So let's go ahead. So, okay, before we starting with the 5 minute charts for the next 24 hours, or 48 hours, start of next week, end of this week, let's get a view about the 4-hourly chart. And we see, in my opinion, a pretty interesting consolidation, what should I say, very great, or a new scenario, I would explain, a new scenario. Why? Let me shortly explain. Here we see A, of course, in my opinion, of course, A, B, C, D, on how is it now here? Yes, A, B, C, D. No, one moment. Here is it. Okay, now is it? A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, it's not a perfect Elliott wave, I know, higher lows, here, it's not a new low, but I'm not an, how to say, accurate or fanatic Elliott waver, but Elliott waves, I'm simply using it as identifying trends, yes, how to say in English, yes, identifying trends. And I'm thinking we are in a one, of course we are in a one since 2-3 weeks, and the question is will we stay in or break it out in the next week? So here I'm painting out two lines too, of course. And we see here the low 4 hour, it was pretty low, a little bit higher as December, but even of the last year, of course, so a pretty interesting low. Okay, for a better context. And yes, and we are A, B, C, D, We see here the consolidation see around about autumn, back to school season, then the high in November, and then here lows again. And after the year, after starting of this year, and then a great bull trend. Bull trend. It's a bull trend on intraday. You see it much better here on the larger picture. A little bit small, but it's a great bull trend in cable. And the question is, of course, yes, we are trading here probably a little bit above. Yes, will the trend continue or perhaps falling back in this area? Okay, so here I'm painting inside the turnaround formation, so C, and it works. We see here on E, it works. We are back above A. So, and after D, also works, but then we've got a sellout. So I'm painting here the gray line, here D consolidation, consolidation with the highs, and here after the sellout we fall. We've got something, how to say, in reverse. Yes, try come back in this D area if you want, perhaps to create to create a much broader consolidation, but it doesn't, failed. So we fall back here under A and created here this area. So, and now we are back above A, and the question is, which I'm asking myself, or probably most all traders which are trading this currency, yes, will we fall back here down under A, or will we break out and still got a bull trend, or on intraday basis, of course, not a long-term intraday short-term bull trend. Okay, yes, tomorrow employment data is from the US, of course, important, and let's get a view on it. Okay, tomorrow are important data right here, right now, since, yes, 3 minutes, Federal Reserve Bank Chief Fisher, of course, presents an update on the economy and monetary policy. We will see in a few minutes live it will be impact or not. Then tomorrow 9 o'clock Central European time, of course, Halifax house prices, where's GP, UK house prices, and CIPS service PMI. Then impact T-bill action, 182 days, 28 days, 91, 92 days bill action. Also, and the most impact will be, of course, or will have the non-farm payrolls, the private payrolls, and the unemployed rate, of course. Interesting, the weekly changes are the lowest since 08. So, yes, it will be interesting, and take a view on it. It will be high volatility. In which way, I of course don't know, but to this fact, I prepared a new chart. Okay, and here it's once again the 4-hourly chart, necked if you want. And here are the timeline, always as the unemployment data comes out. And we see here in the next one, the influence, perhaps the influence, I'm trying to put it in the context. Here we see down under is always the exception always in black, then red failed. And yes, no, it's in the trend. So if we are here, for example, 9-1 was the exception, of course. 9-2 failed. So usually we accepted higher prices, lower dollar, and it works even in by the June data, of course, in July, at the 8th, 7th July come out. So the same way in August here, as yes, the exception was 9-2, 9-1 come out, yes, and in the next month, the until the next data, the cable was lower, even the dollar higher. Don't understand me wrong. I'm not saying that the price is rising or falling of this data or the cause of this data, but it's an influence. One, how do you say, catalysator? Yeah, one function. Of course, one function, one added function. Yes, or adding function. Here we see in September 9-1, 9-1 was in line. October also, but we see here in November, of course, 9 was acceptation was 9, or accepted was 9, real 9 was 9, yes, and 9-1 came out, so disappointed, and we've got a stronger dollar. And here a great outbeat was it in December, of course. Then 9 was accepted, 8-6 came out, and we've got still nine. One moment. Yes, of course, I've got a hangover. Yes, wrong conclusion. By my way, okay, let's go ahead. Here we see in December, great outbeat, 9. Was accepted, 8-6 came out, and yes, and we saw higher dollar, lower cable. So that's the way it was. Okay, and the last one we've got better than accepted. 8.5 came out, 8.7 was the exception, but we've got higher prices. So yes, put it in a context like you want. Analyze the stuff again, it's still yours. And we've got here a divergence. And the question is, of course, what will happen today? Yes, perhaps I should put it also in the context. Today, the 3rd February. $16.30 is by my broker at the time. Of course. So, and it will be interesting. It was always high volatility. We don't see it here on the fall chart, but if we were zooming, we would see it much better. And of course, that's a slightly fundamentally info service for you to get a better understanding for the employment data. Yes, interesting is, of course, to put it or to end it with the fundamental data. If we are watching the unemployment data in all other countries, they are much more rising than falling. Perhaps in America, in the last quarter or last half year, lower. And by the way, we are all hoping that it will be better. However, of course, here in the end, to come to the end, I'm put this all in our chart. Here our chart. Here the chart, technical. Here the fundamental, in context of the unemployment data. Here put it all together. And interesting is, of course, we are here on the backtrack of A. So that will be surely an catalyst or function in which way we will go next week. So that's all the basic signal why I'm putting the unemployment data in this video too. Okay. Interesting for us for the next 48 hours or until today or next week is of course last event after E, A, B, C, E. And with E, this scenario or this formation is for me ended. It's ending for me. So here, yes, and we are here right now after this rally in a new scenario. Okay. Okay, here broke this line, broke this line, and now perhaps falling back or here, but that shouldn't have any, in my opinion, any conclusions, how do you say in English, yes, with that actual, with this formation. Here, but if we are falling here sharply back under this line, then we are still in this trend. So, but I don't accept it or can't imagine it. But it's possible and it's also a capability. But I'm not accepting it. Let me stay honestly. So what I'm okay. So, but now let's zoom a little bit and analyze this line. So here is it, that here you see E and this upside trend on 30 minutes, and we see the fall start of the year. Perhaps we could look back here, we see the end of the year, then as the year begin also sell off, and then proudly upside trend. So, and here's also my technical signal or my trading signal, my trading capability for you is I would still prefer the long side here, of course, at we are here right now at 1.58. I would prefer the long side. Take even the stop, take the stop here by the A line. The A line is by my broker. Take the stop by 78, so very small stop. Stop if you have more well, risk aversion, I would take the stop here. Here, but I would much prefer here the stop even by 1.5780, and I would likely short after this break, after the if the cable fall back on this upside trend, I would probably short the cable. So, but I would still prefer the long side and hoping that we are rising up here about this trend line by 1.5887, and that would be a much better option. Of course, you can You can also hoping and buying in this area, hoping that the price comes down and buy again. But if the upside trend broke, then broke, and that would even be for me a short signal, and the price target where would be for me one here this downside trend. So, and if this broke, yeah, then we are back in the main picture, but I'm don't accepting it here, as I'm saying, start of the trading video. So I would still try to go long in this area, of course, here, try to go long in this area, make the stop here, and if we are falling out, okay, not much losses, 20 pips, and if we are coming back, I would buy again in this area. So, okay, but stay aware, last time this area high speculative didn't work, and we are in new area since November, and November, to put it now all in the context, November here, it was much higher unemployment data, and yes, if we've got much more data, perhaps we'll push it the dollar, and then we will not see perhaps prices in this area for longer term. So it will be very exciting tomorrow, in my opinion, of course. So very interesting area here once again. Put it in a big context. Very interesting area. Very interesting formation. And yes, very interesting cross pair, of course, the cable. High volatility, also in intraday basis, and we will see tomorrow. To come to an end, let's get a view of the 5 minute charts here. And we see here. Here we see we are trading something a little bit above this line, 1.55. So, and of course, and here is the stop by 1.15780, and I would take the stop here, and if we are falling back, we are out, and if we are coming back, I would buy again, so 20 pips, not much, okay. And yes, we saw these prices here. Okay, interesting perhaps the trading sessions, of course, here, the trading sessions here without, here with, today, Wes and London, yesterday, or not, yesterday, Central European Human Time, of course, here, or let me say the Thursday trading session, here the Wednesday trading session, we see this uprise, and here also the reason, or perhaps one reason again, why the cable started course this line, important technical line, here. Here, we see here, in the bigger picture. So, perhaps, and that's the reason why I'm said at first that this we've got a new scenario. So, okay, as yes, we've in a new scenario, in my opinion. Okay, here once again, Thursday, Wednesday, Tuesday, here on Monday, lower prices. Okay, so, okay, put this all in a technical context. Here we see NECT back connect, and here with some lines. I'm creating here also a line. It was the high. So here, the high on Tuesday. The high is on Tuesday. So here, we see here, the high is on Tuesday. And interesting is that the highs of Tuesday are the lows of yesterday. So we've got perhaps on Wednesday something like a turnaround on intraday, on a short term. And if we are watching this in a bigger context, we see it a new scenario. So very interesting, very exciting, fascinating. And yes, we will see what will happen tomorrow or in the next 14 hours. Yes, 13 hours we will see. And perhaps we've got something like a recovery in America, and we will see, of course, when the unemployment data comes down from its highs. It comes down, it was by 10, if I'm not wrong, now by 8.5. Then yes, QE, operation twist, everything are working. But I don't want to give you here an economic outview much more for traders, but it's interesting, and it's one function what's driving the cable. Okay, come back, or let's put it in end. Here we see the highs of Tuesday, then the breakout on Wednesday, and here the lows of Thursday, yes, Thursday trading session are even the lows. And okay, so we're back in line. Interesting for us, even for the next 48 hours, is this downside trend, or for me, here the high outbreaks, the two highs, and the second outbreak also failed. Was a fails breakout, how do you say in English? Yes. So we will see what will happen. Yes, perhaps I should put here in the context here the cross line is about 11, 12 o'clock Central European Time, 6 o'clock New York. It's from time space, mathematic, an interesting point on the short view. So be aware. And interesting, of course, too, the opening. Okay, I don't need to put it in context. Is then here. Perhaps we will see it here, yes. Here, of course. Here we see when London will open, and here on the white, then New York. So. And I would still prefer the long side, take the stop here. If we are falling out, we are falling out, squeeze out. And if we are come back, I would still prefer the long side. So, of course, interesting here in this context. Of course, if we are falling down, we will see perhaps this option will working okay. So okay, that will working this trading capability will work end of the week if we are falling down, and if we see prices after or down under this upside trend, I will make a switch. I don't like moves like this, very speculative, because if you're starting to switch, intraday, then yes, you can switch as long as you can, but by the end you will lose the most money will making your broker. So, by the way, I would to come to an end. I will go long, make a stop here, and if this line will be broken, the upside trend since 1 to 3 weeks, I will prefer the dollar. So, and we will see the catalyst or the function tomorrow will be surely the unemployment data, of course. Okay. Yo, that's all. Here the intraday chart. We are now about 1.5802, 024. So take this bond, take care, analyze the stuff again. It's still yours. I'm over and out. Wish you best. Your best. Have a great trading day tomorrow. I will not twittering tomorrow. Need to do something another. And enjoy the Super Bowl, of course, if I'm not wrong. On weekend, yes, of course. Enjoy. You see, you're listening. I've got another things to do than watching right here, right now. But it will be interesting, and yes, it will be exciting, even like tomorrow. The cable, Patriots Giants, of course, of course, and the cable tonight or tomorrow. Okay, Patriots and Giants, Knights and Cowboys. Wish you the best. I'm over and out. Good day, good morning, good night, and stay aware. Thank you.